Whaling, the act of commercially killing whales. Whales have been killed for their meat and blubber for thousands of years, but the practice became a booming industry in the 18th and 19th century, but was quickly outlawed in the 20th century. The issue of whaling is controversial, and some countries flat out refuse to abide by anti-whaling laws. But what if we never hunted them in the first place? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if we never hunted whales? Before we get into this video, I want to know if you have ever seen a whale, and if not, what is the biggest fish you've ever seen? I'm actually going to Victoria in British Columbia in Canada in June, and I hope to see some whales then. Whales! Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below, and also if you like our content, please do leave a thumbs up and share this video with a friend. Check out our source links in the description box to learn more, and also check out the links to the social medias of the people who went into making this video. Stick around to the end where I'm going to be responding to some comments. Okay, let's do this. Understanding why we hunted whales helps us to understand what life would have been like if we never did it. The reason the practice was started in the first place was primarily as a food resource for local oceanside communities. But in the pre-electricity industrial era, oil harvested from whales was found to keep flames used for lights burning brighter and longer. And beyond that, their oil was used to lubricate machinery, especially in wartime. Whale blubber has been used in cosmetics, and some parts of whale intestines are used to create perfumes. Whale bones were also used in clothing in the 18th and 19th centuries. Beyond the historic uses for whales, in more modern times, whaling has been conducted for quote-unquote scientific research. Whaling became an issue in around the 1930s, when it was discovered that 45,000 to 50,000 whales each year were being killed, which was actually very much harming the ocean health. This provoked the whaling convention that put tighter restrictions on the practice. By the 1940s, blue whales and sperm whales were being hunted to near extinction, and by 1986, the practice was by and large banned. Although, Japan, Norway, and Iceland generally ignore the rules and continue the practice for a number of reasons, mostly for cultural heritage, and others, again, for quote-unquote science. Let's tackle the question of oil first. There is no doubt that oil harvested from whales from the 17th to 19th centuries helped keep things light at night, but had we never had the resource, we would have kept up with demand for oil by using other materials. We may have turned to paraffin oil, which would have been worse for the atmosphere and breathable gases. Whale oil was also used heavily in World War I for munitions on all sides. It's not likely that the lack of whale oil would have had any bearing on the outcome of the war, but it was during this time that whaling was at its highest. Had we not killed so many whales throughout this time period, it is likely our oceans and air quality would have been healthier. Why? Well, you may be surprised to know the answer is whale poo. Whale poo is an excellent fertilizer. With more whales in the ocean at this time, had we not killed them, then there would likely be more plankton as a result of the more fertile environment. This plankton not only feeds smaller fish and animals, it also helps absorb carbon dioxide, which is vital to maintaining our breathable air. Right now, approaching the second decade of the 21st century, carbon dioxide levels in our atmospheres are unsustainable and are contributing to global warming, which is a major issue. If we hadn't hunted whales, this would likely still be the case, but perhaps the levels would be safer and easier to manage. The use of whale blubber has been stopped in cosmetics, thankfully, although it is still found in some products. It is pretty wild to make assumptions on whaling and the cosmetic industry, but perhaps had we not been okay with harvesting animals for use in cosmetics, we'd be wearing less makeup, although I doubt that. Rather, we would have found different ways to make them. That being said, I do have to wonder if the use of whale blubber further justified cruelty towards animals in the cosmetic industry for so many years. The hardest issue when it comes to whaling, which I think perhaps we can agree isn't a legit modern day practice, is that in history it has undoubtedly saved many people from starvation. In Alaska, indigenous groups are still allowed to hunt whales for sustenance, and after the World Wars, whaling may have helped save millions of Japanese lives as the country starved as a result of their terrible economic downturn. If we never hunted whales, it is likely that things would have been much more catastrophic for Japan, and those who live in more remote parts of the world lacking in food resources except for whales would have had a much tougher time surviving. To this day though, Japanese, Norwegian, and Icelandic people still eat whales on a much smaller scale, although tourist appetites for the meat has dropped very low. These nations argue that they hunt the non-endangered minke whales, but Iceland does indeed hunt hunt the endangered finback. These days, eating whale meat is not essential for survival in these affluent nations, and the reason they still do it today largely comes down to cultural preservation, and again, the guise of science. Japan is the most staunch in their defense against anti-whaling because, again, science. So I was trying to research some scientific breakthroughs that have been made by killing whales so I could point you towards what the world might look like had we never hunted them, but I can't find any real breakthroughs that have been made from whaling. Indeed, Australia argue that research could be just as fruitful without actually killing the whales. In terms of historical economy, whaling was very lucrative for the UK, America, Iceland, Norway, and Japan. In the mid-1800s, whaling was one of the most lucrative industries in the United States, bringing in $10 million a year, which at the time was big bucks. Had we never hunted whales, some of these countries would not have been as well off, but especially when discussing America anyway, I'm sure they would have found other ways to bank the big bucks. These days, whale watching tours are big tourism draws. Like I said, I'm off to Victoria and BC for whale watching soon. If we never killed them, there would be more whales in the ocean, and perhaps the whale watching industry would be even bigger than it is today. Ultimately, what's done is done in terms of whaling, and the practice definitely did have some historic benefits. But as we move on as a global society, killing whales does not seem to be in our best interest for ocean health. Plus, many others argue it's simply cruel. We have the ability to generate oil more sustainably, and we have the ability to farm more sustainable food, so why are we still hunting whales? That is the end of the video, and for me, it is hard to know how the world would be when something like a background industry didn't take place, but I'm sure that there would be subtle differences in the way we approach consumption today. Japan, for example, may have been very different had all of its people starved after World War II. So what do you guys think the world would be like if we never killed whales? Do you think that we should stop? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. I'm particularly interested in hearing from people from Iceland, Norway, and Japan because I'm sure you guys have a deeper cultural insight. Also, don't forget everyone to let me know if you have ever seen a whale, and if not, what's the biggest creature you have ever seen in water? Thank you guys once again for watching this video. Please do leave a thumbs up and share it with a friend. Before I go, I'm just gonna read some comments from one of my most recent videos, What If We Shot Our Trash Into Space? Good old Kim Jong-un was sliding into the comments and said, What if the Pacific Ocean was clean? Ooh, very good question. Lots of plastic is actually found in whale bellies today. Cobra said, Idea, why don't we just burn our trash? Not in a volcano, but in burning factories. And yes, we would pollute our air. I think you just answered your own question there, because pollution and choking to death. David Jack said, What if YouTube servers went down for 1 month? Ah, anxiety. Actually, our internet went down for like 5 minutes before filming this video, and I was very, very freaked out. So if YouTube went down for a month, well, whew. Chaos, chaos, boom, boom, drama. Anyway, I think that's that. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. Do catch us in a future video of Life's Biggest Questions, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.